CEN News, देश प्रदेश की ताजा तरीन खबरों के लिए CEN News को सब्सक्राइब करें और रहें पल पल की खबर से हर पल बाखबर.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's really cold out here today. And talking about cold, the government seems to have developed rather a cold shoulder towards another issue. Yes, I am talking about the Jawaharlal Nehru University fee hike issue and the significance of the ongoing protests regarding it. Well, before we talk about it, one thing we all will agree that there has been massive privatization of the education system in our country, and this is a burden on the shoulders of a common man. A question that arises, that is this a new phenomena? Well, over the years, the education policies of the successive government is responsible for the privatization of education system in our country. When we talk about the government policy, the neo-economic policy or the neo-liberalization policies of the successive Congress regimes has led to this privatization of the education system. But we did expect some changes from the new government, but all we have got is a dismissal because there seems to be no major shift in the education policy of the new government, and all this has led to crass commercialization of the education system in our country. And there, it seems to be true that the government, the state, has abdicated its responsibility. As I earlier said, that India is a welfare state and education is supposed to be one of its top priority along with other sectors like health, but such is not the scenario when we talk about the figures. Talking about the statistics, in higher sector, up to 67% is the privatization, though the figures are better when we talk about the lower education sector. Here the privatization is just 37%. And when we talk about the fee hike issue, this issue is not just contained to one or JNU. When we talk about IIT's fellowship program, there has been seen a fee hike over there also. Down south, if I have to name, the Pondicherry University, there has been fee hike issue. Whether I talk about the prestigious Tata Institute of Social Sciences in Maharashtra, there also has been a fee hike cases. And up north, whether we talk about private schools in Delhi and Shimla, wherever we go, the list goes on, but the fee hike continues to be an issue. So how does it affect us? Well, for one, it is definitely a strain on the parents. For any class the parents may belong to, it definitely is a cause of concern for them. But especially talking about the class, the economically marginalized class, they cannot give the benefits, the educational benefits to their children if the fee hike continues. And it seems that it goes on the whims and fancies of these private players. When we talk about JNU, the whole media narrative was that the JNU students were paying just mere rupees 20 on a single occupancy room of the hostel, and from there the fee hike has been there, but the increase has been from rupees 20 to almost rupees 300, and the fee has reached up to rupees 62,000 per annum. So I want you to imagine for a moment a family whose income is just rupees 10,000 per month. For this family to afford rupees 62,000 per year is really a big deal. And let us admit that the institutes like JNU, the very ethos for which these institutes had been built, it is to provide the benefits of a higher education to all. Institutes like JNU are meant to be inclusive, and we cannot make them exclusive by, you know, making these institutes non-available to these economically marginalized sections. So it is very important that the government needs to take a stand onto it. If a government can afford to build statues of amounting to 3,000 crores, if we can afford scams like PNB scams and other NPAs, then I'm sure the government can afford to spend few thousands of taxpayers' money on these institutes, where there is no denying the fact that these institutes have given us some of the most socially aware and most responsible citizens of the country. I really hope the government will change its education policy and be more empathetic towards the student community, especially the economically marginalized community. Jai Hind!